the morning star, drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Thursday, September 9th, and this is the Morningstar Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is going on today? On this wonderful Thursday, we've got coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, question and answer Thursday, and of course the brand new segment from Yuan Yu in Singapore. It is sports science, and we'll be doing it for another 4 weeks. So, how are you guys doing today? Yes, it is Thursday. We just had a wonderful Wednesday message from our head leaders. Hope you guys really enjoyed that. Just want to kind of give you guys an apology for yesterday's podcast. Yes, the sound on my voice was a little bit soft. I'm hoping that it's going to be fixed by today's. I'm speaking louder and closer to the mic. I think it's because I'm not in my studio and the settings aren't going to be the same as they were before. So I'm going to make sure that the sound on this one is going to be much, much better. All right. Thanks, Tim, for bringing that up. So it is Thursday. We're getting to the end of the week and hope you guys really enjoyed the service. So let's get today's day started together on the Morningstar Drive. Just want to remind everyone to keep liking and commenting. And thank you for the comments on what love is. Really, really thankful for that. And I want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing and other things too. Also, Espresso with Sky, the video is coming out tonight at 6 p.m. in LA time, 6 p.m. So that's Pacific Standard. It'll be 9 p.m. in New York. And of course, it will be like 9 a.m. on Friday. For those of you in Asia, 9 or 10 a.m., whether you're in Malaysia or Korea, right? So this week's video is going to be on Jacob wrestling with God. Did Jacob really wrestle with God? And what was Sunstein's answer to this, okay? And of course, also this Sunday, we'll be meeting another member from around the world. This week, we met Joycelyn Sin from Singapore. Very grateful for her time spent to do this interview. Super inspiring. So make sure to catch this week's Sunday edition. And of course, we're going to meet someone else from around the world. So hope you guys will really enjoy that one too. So let's get into today's featured artist of the day. Today's featured artist is going to be Bach from the Paper Music Associates in Korea. We haven't heard from him in a while. And we're going to listen to his latest single called True Story. And that's featuring PGY. Second song is RJR, Rising Japan Radio. And that song is Universe. And last but not least, we have Renee Lai from Taiwan. And that's, I believe it's a cover from A Star Is Born soundtrack. And it's Always Remember Us This Way. All right, guys, as we're doing this 70-day prayer condition, I hope more than anything else, you will keep all of these member artists in your prayers.
Yeah. 반에서 잘 나갔어 나중 학교 다닐 때 애들 앞에 나서는 게 매일 반복됐던 하루네 선비 앞에선 고개 숙여 인사해 수업했던 땐 고개 푹 숙여 시간 때워 공부 따윈 잘해봤자 형과 비교돼 쟤 누구 동생이란 소린 귀에 박혀 내 두개 골을 강타해 그게 싫어 계속 다른 나로 바뀌었네 선배들과 알게 돼 강요당한 불량 서클 그러면서 산에 불려 친구들과 구타당해왔어 정말 엄마한테 말 못해 내 맘 한켠 묻혀있던 주께 편지 써보니 주님께 편지 보낸 이후 주민 신고 받고 경찰 출동해 선배 잡았고 어둠 속 그곳에서 꺼내준 내 주께 감사해 새 삶을 배워가네 yeah 가르침에 난 입학한 고등학교 다니며 자꾸 튀어나온 네버를 따시려가 나의 꿈 문나같이 방황하던 모든 사람들이 주를 만난 삶의 변화 이루어 기뻐하는 것 yeah. 하루 삶을 살며 뜻해온 대로 시간 또 깨어 미련 없이 실컷 탔어 오늘도 주 따라 평소 하던 것보다 더 힘내시련 닥쳐와도 나 지난 날 사연으로 결국엔 이겨가 지금은 질 것 같아도 보고 놀라지 결과 사람들은 말해 지금을 즐기자고 꼭 해결할 문제는 동전 마냥 던져놓고 누구든 해결해야 할 영문제 문제가 있어. 그 문제 풀지 못하면 남는 건 아무것도 없어. 함께 인생 백년 영에 대해 배우고 나의 육도 감독해. 생각만 앞세우다 끝나버릴 뻔했어. 세상 최고 재벌이라도 때는 못 나가. 참 안타까운 일이지만 방도는 있어. 신의 생각대로 사는 것 묵은 양식은 희마리가 없지만 난 새 양식 먹으니 바로 힘이 나. 이젠 나 놓치지 않아. 내 인생 한 대뿐 더 많이 배우고 또 가르쳐 줄래. 생각나 아파했던 날 주님 떠올라 같이 울고 있던 날 난 내게 말해 나 같은 사람 지켜주심에 참 감사하다고. 난 생각나 아파했던 날 주님 떠올라 같이 울고 있던 날 난 내게 말해 나 같은 사람 지켜주심에 참 감사하다고. 난 생각나 아파했던 날 주님 떠올라 같이 울고 있던 날 또 내게 말해 나 같은 사람 지켜주심에 참 감사하다고. 난 생각나 아파했던 날 주님 떠올라 같이 울고 있던 날 오늘도 말해 나 같은 사람 같이 알려주심에 참 감사하다고.
stories on a sky burning in your eyes. You look at me and babe, I wanna catch on fire. It's buried in my soul like California gold. You found the light in me that I couldn't find. So when I'm all choked up and I can't find the words, every time we say goodbye, baby, it hurts. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Lovers in the night, poets trying to write. We don't know how to rhyme, but then we try. But all I really know, you're where I wanna go. The part of me that you will never die. So when
that is Renee Lai from Taiwan with Always Remember Us This Way, and that is from the A Star Is Born soundtrack. Before that, we have Universe from RJR, Rising Japan Radio, and the feature artist of the day is Bach from the Paper Moon Associates in Korea with True Story featuring PGY. So let's get into some coronavirus updates going on around the world. We have 223 million cases, 4.6 million deaths, and a 2.06% mortality rate. Top five countries, kind of everything's leveling out back to where it was before. We have the U.S. on top, 107,000 cases in a day with 815 deaths. India, 38,000 cases, 368 deaths. The UK, 37,000 cases, 209 deaths in a single day. Iran, 27,000 cases, 635 deaths. And a new number five, it is Turkey with 23,000 cases and 274 deaths. Over here in North America, of course, the US is on top with over 100,000 cases. Mexico with 5,100 cases in a day with 330 deaths. And Canada, kind of going up, 3,300 cases, but only 12 deaths. So good job to Canada, which I will be going to soon within the next couple of months. All right, so let's get into the top three news going on around the world. And we're starting with news from the WHO. We haven't heard from them in a while. And they are urging rich countries to hold off on booster shots until 2022. So the agency chief calls for an extension of proposed moratorium on COVID-19 vaccine booster shots to enable every country to inoculate to at least 40% of its population. Of course, in the past, they asked for every country to hold off on booster shots to reach 10%, so I'm sure they reached that already. The head of the WHO has called on wealthy countries with large supplies of coronavirus vaccines to refrain from offering booster shots through the end of the year, expanding an earlier request that has been largely ignored. So speaking to journalists on Wednesday in Geneva, WHO Director General Tedros we'll just call him Director General Tedros. He also said he was appalled at comments by a leading association of pharmaceutical manufacturers a day earlier who said vaccine supplies are high enough to allow for both booster shots and vaccinations in countries in dire need of jabs but facing shortages. So Tedros had previously called for a moratorium on booster shots through the end of September, but rich countries including Israel, the UK, Denmark, France, Germany, Spain, and the US have begun or are considering plans to offer third shots of two-dose vaccines to their vulnerable people, such as the elderly or those who compromised immune systems. Now, the WHO chief said he received a message of clear support from health ministers at a meeting of the influential group of 20 countries this month for a commitment to help hit a target that all countries vaccinate at least 40% of their people by year's end. About 80% of the 5.5 billion vaccines, 80% of the 5.5 billion vaccine doses that have been administered globally went to high-income countries, and rich countries have also offered to donate 1 billion vaccine doses to other countries, but fewer than 15% of those doses have materialized. And he noted that manufacturers have pledged to prioritize a UN-backed program to get vaccines to the neediest people in the world. In second news, we're going to go back to Canada. Experts in Canada are alarmed by anti-Trudeau protests. Angry protests at Canadian Prime Minister's election campaign stops prompt extremism experts to warn of possible rising violence. So throngs of angry protesters hurling epithets and denouncing coronavirus vaccines and lockdown measures are becoming a fixture at Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau's election campaign stops. And in London, Ontario, on Monday, gravel was thrown at Trudeau from a crowd of demonstrators, many of whom held signs for the far-right People's Party of Canada as he was getting back into his campaign bus. And it was the latest rally of what Trudeau has dubbed as anti-vaxxer mobs to interrupt the Liberal Party leaders' campaign events ahead of the September 20th vote. While it's unclear what motivated each of the protesters on Monday, footage from the event showed groups of demonstrators waving signs for the PPC, a far-right party that has no seats in parliament and is polling at less than 5%. And the Liberal leader described the protesters shouting epithets at him, his supporters, police officers and journalists as anti-vaxxer mobs. And he added that healthcare and other frontline workers in Canada have faced similar harassment. Now, Canada has inoculated much of its population against the coronavirus, but the spread of the highly contagious Delta variant has raised concerns of a fourth wave, prompting some provinces to announce plans to impose vaccine passport systems for entry into restaurants, bars, gyms, and other indoor public places. So that's what's going on in Canada. I won't be there for the election, but if I was, personally, I would not vote for Justin Trudeau. Just my thing is I don't like his policies more than anything else. But either way, nothing about the party, Liberal Party. I think my parents are voting Liberal, but definitely I just don't like him. Not the other people. He's just total moron. Just some of the things I heard, just so sad to hear it. Like I'm gonna tell you this one thing I was telling other people yesterday about is like he basically. There's someone who asked about something to do with the word mankind, and then he stopped the person and said, not mankind, but peoplekind. And he doesn't understand that mankind is short for humankind. It's not about man like the males, but he stopped them and said, no, it's for humankind. For peoplekind. I'm just like, gosh, he's just way too to the left, like extreme. I don't mind the left. I just don't like it when it's super extreme. But either way, very interesting. Last but not least, we'll get into the third. There's more voting going on in Morocco, but there is widespread apathy. So elections in Morocco marked by voter apathy and low turnout due to disenchantment with political parties. Moroccan voters are heading to the polls to choose a new parliament and local leaders in elections that have been reshaped by the pandemic amid widespread disillusionment with the political system. About 18 million people were expected to cast their ballots on Wednesday, the third time since a new constitution was introduced in 2011 in the wake of the February 20th movement, the local version of the Arab Spring. However, as few political reforms have materialized since the popular uprising, the turnout rate is expected to be as low as 35%. So as low as midday yesterday, around 12% of registered voters had cast their ballots, the interior minister said. And Morocco, you guys got to know, is a constitutional monarchy where the king holds sweeping powers. He picks the prime minister from the party that wins the most seats in parliament and appoints key ministers, right? So all the power is with the king. And the palace also sets the economic agenda for the country of 37 million people and has commissioned a new development model that the new government is asked to implement. So the new constitution adopted in 2011 was supposed to move the country closer to a system of constitutional monarchy, but it did not alter the king's central role. As a result, regardless of who holds elected office, major decisions come from the palace, including during the coronavirus crisis. So a lot of people were are heard saying there's no point of voting because it's not going to improve the situation because politicians only care about themselves, or the king does all the work anyway. So what's going to happen with this voting? 395 deputies in the House of Representatives and 678 seats in regional councils under a new law that calculates the allocations of seats based on the number of registered voters rather than the number of those who actually cast a ballot. So that is a top three news going on today. Let's get on to some sporting news. We'll start off with tennis. Really happy about a Canadian women's tennis player. Her name is Layla Fernandez. This is the U.S. Open right now. Incredible fighter. First, she defeated Naomi Osaka, then Angelique Kerber, right after Alina Svitolina, and basically two former world number ones, two Grand Slam champions, two top five players. Fernandez is the youngest to make the U.S. Open semifinals since Maria Sharapova in 2005, and is the first player to beat two top five players in the same major since Serena Williams in 1999. She's only 19 years old. Yes, and she's representing Canada, so great for her. Good job. Also, in NBA news, we have the new class of the Hall of Fame, which includes people that I grew up with, like Chris Webber, Chris Bosh, Paul Pierce, Ben Wallace, Tony Kukoc. So they're all going to be inducted to the Hall of Fame there. And last but not least, we have soccer World Cup qualifying action. Korea beats Lebanon 1-0. Japan beats China 1-0. And of course, over there in Europe, France beats Finland 2-0. All right. So that is the news for today. Hope you guys really enjoyed that. That means we're going to go into a time of, we'll call it the golden time. And yes, in this golden time, I hope a lot of you guys will enjoy it, having a time of praise and worship. And I thought, especially with this week's message about love, we got to get into songs of love. Yeah. Love. I mean, it actually sounds like disgusting love when I say it like that. But either way, let's get into some songs about love. And we're going to start off with Only the Lord is My Love. Amen. And then I Love the Lord, amen. And then we'll end off with The Path of Love. And that's another amen. So I hope you guys, as one body of the Morning Star Drive, to spend this time giving praise, honor, and glory to the Holy Trinity.
The Lord is my true salvation. Me alone is my everything. that I am belongs to him. I'm in love with only the lover.
Spirit. I have come, you've come as well. And today we become one with God, one with the Spirit. We unite on this path, this path of love we must walk. Now and for all eternity, this path will never change. Hear the word flows without end. Proudly we go on, always for providence. Now and always hope will shine brighter than the sun. This eternal love and hope forever shine. Love of ours fulfilled God's will at last. The Lord our God promises will not fail, they will stand without change.
There you have it. That is The Path of Love. What a deep, amazing song, The Path of Love. Before that, I Love the Lord, and of course, Only the Lord is My Love, with today's theme about love. All right, guys, so let's get into today's word study, and of course, we all know that Thursday, it is Question and Answer Thursday. So what does that mean for all of us here? What is the question coming? And the question, I got this from a member that asked me this question is, what is the best way to lecture a newcomer for the first time? Okay, so this basically means this is their first lecture ever. They're really, really nervous. What are the things that they need to focus on more than anything else? And of course, the number one answer I give to everyone before anything else is, if you have never lectured before and it's going to be your first time and you have a newcomer, like a real life, right? Like someone who's never learned the word and you're going to teach for the very first time, of course, you're going to be super nervous, okay? And the first thing I would, the first piece of advice I always tell everyone is, you need to prepare. That's the number one thing more than anything else. Don't just wing it. Don't just think that you're done with it. You need to prepare. Now, what does it mean to prepare? So number one is, and this is what I learned from Pastor Joan when I was over doing lecture training and helping out lecturers over there, especially people who are new lecturers, the number one thing is you need to listen to a lot of lectures. Right? So if you can do Peter and the Fish, listen to a lot of them. And even for myself, when I first taught, my first lesson was Peter and the Fish. I listened to 4 different lectures over 2 days, took all like a bunch of notes, the things I was inspired by. So you want to listen to a lot of lectures, you want to take a lot of notes, and then for preparation is practice. You need to practice in front of a mirror, do it multiple times until you're very, very comfortable speaking. And then on top of this, it's good to practice in front of other members or even your leader. And now I know it's going to be a little bit embarrassing, like, oh my gosh, they know more than me. But the whole purpose of it is just to get it out, right? A lot of times what you think in your mind and what you're going to say and when it actually comes out are very, very different, right? So, you know, you need to practice a lot in the mirror and also on other members. Okay, so there's the first one is preparation, which is listening to a lot of lectures, taking a lot of notes, and practicing a lot in front of the mirror and other members, okay? Second advice I give to people is get advice from other lecturers, okay? If there's anything, when Sun Sim gave 70 things that leaders must do, if you want to be a leader, the number one thing is always learn, which means get advice from other lecturers. Always, there's always something to learn, something better. They'll give you these tips and hints and you're like, oh, that makes so much sense. And there are some things that I'm going to give you hints on, but other people will give you other hints too. So it's really, really good with that too, okay? So, and also, you know, when you're getting advice from other lecturers, listen, you know, this kind of has to do with number one and two together is your purpose of listening to other lecturers or getting other people to listen to you is not to compare because you can't compare. It's your first lecture. It is to learn. Okay. So listen to other lecturers, not to compare, but to learn, right? Teach other people, teach other members, show them your lecture, not to compare and let them compare with themselves. No, it's to learn. Everything is about learning more than anything else, okay? So you're there to learn, not to compare. So get advice from other lecturers, all right? And when you think about it in this way, you're not going to take things too personally. And that's something that's really good. Don't take things personally, okay? The third advice I have for you guys doing for the first time is don't give yourself an excuse to be bad. Okay, now this is something that it's more of when you start to teach like a newcomer, okay? When you're starting to teach a newcomer, don't give excuses before the lecture that you're going to be bad. There's no point in that, right? Don't say stuff like, oh, this is my first time, so if I'm not that good, don't say that stuff. Oh, I haven't done this before, don't say that, right? And don't say, oh, you're my first person I've ever lectured, so if it's not good, no. You guys gotta have confidence when you're going in there. Confidence in what? Not confidence in yourself. It is confidence that God and the Holy Spirit are going to be working through you. All right? That is a massive thing. It's not about, you know, yes, you might not have confidence in yourself, but you need to realize that it is not you doing the lecture. Yes, you're speaking the words, but ultimately you are preparing for the Holy Spirit and God to work through you so that it will touch this person's heart. Right, and of course, that is something that you need to do a lot. Of course, that's in preparation that I forgot to add is prayer. Like, you know, you got to make sure you pray a lot for the lecture itself, praying for the Holy Spirit to work through you, praying for the Holy Spirit to inspire you more than anything else. Okay, so that is something that, you know, don't qualify yourself. Oh, I've never done this before. It's okay. Don't worry about it. Have confidence in God. Have confidence in the Holy Spirit that they will work through you. And I'm gonna give you a little experience for me too. Sometimes, as a lecturer, sometimes I begin to trust too much in myself that I'm a good lecturer, so it's going to be good because of my skill. But I know there's a bunch of times where God proves me wrong, where I felt it was a terrible lecture. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I did such a poor job. And this is when I start to focus too much on myself. But later on, these newcomers were like, man, that was so awesome. I loved it. And when I hear that, it reminds me of, hey, it's not you. The bulk of the work is coming from God, right? So this is why we really need to understand that it is not you, it is God. So don't give yourself an excuse, because you're actually giving an excuse for God, right? You're giving an excuse for God. Like saying God's not going to work that hard. No, guys, you have to be confident. And you might be like, hey, this is my first time, but hey, don't worry about it. Don't worry. Let God work through it. Get your preparations done. Make sure you pray and allow God to work through you, right? And that's something that's really, really going to help you out in the future, okay? The fourth advice I have for you guys is, when you're giving the lecture, it's okay to say, I don't know. It's okay. Don't worry. They're not going to look down on you, right? It's okay to say, I don't know. They'll ask you a question or something. If you don't know, the best answer is, oh, I don't know. It's okay. Trust me on this one. And don't just say, I don't know, and then move on. The advice I would give to you is make sure you get the answer to them eventually. So the best thing you could tell them is, hey, great question. I've never heard this question before, and I'm going to get back to you. Let me go ask my pastor about this one, right? And then get the answer and make sure you tell the newcomer later. That's part of your integrity, okay? But don't just make up stuff. Don't just say things. You're going to end up, you might be teaching the wrong things or give them the wrong understanding about God, right? So guys, it's okay to say, I don't know. It's okay. Don't worry. It's okay. Great question. I've never heard this question before. That's really awesome that you thought, well, you know, that you thought of a question like this. I'm going to get back to you. You know, I'm going to talk to my pastor and I'll get the answer for you. And they'll appreciate that even more than you fumbling around and trying to make up something. Okay. So it's okay to say, I don't know. And the last one of the top five things that I would kind of tell people is don't worry about the length of the lecture. Right? It's not about the length. It's about whether they understood the lecture or not. That's the big thing, right? You know, that's why Sunstein says sometimes I can teach them in 5 minutes. We're like, whoa. And the key point is, did they understand and grasp the point that you're trying to make? If you can do it in 15 minutes and they really understand it, it's fine. It's better than a 90-minute lecture that the newcomers lost in the key point. As long as they understand, that is key. All right. So don't worry about, oh no, it was only 20 minutes. Don't worry about it. Okay. You know, start it with prayer, end it with prayer. Once it's done, it's done. Ask them if they got any questions, right? And it's something that I know a lot of people are worried. Oh no, it was only 30 minutes. 30 minutes is fine. Honestly, guys, even 25, you can say a lot in 25 minutes. Don't think about you have to give the entire Sunday message and this and that. No. Your lecture is about the lecture. If it's about love, only talk about love. What is pertinent to that? And finish there, right? So what are my five different types of tips I have for people that are lecturing for the first time? Number one is preparation. What is preparation? I'll add that in. Pray. Make sure you pray every day, right? Number two, for preparation, listen to a lot of lectures. Make a lot of notes. And then practice. Practice a lot in the mirror and on other members and leaders. Second advice I have for you is get a lot of advice from other lecturers. There's always something to learn. Remember, the purpose of like teaching all these other different things is not to compare, it's to learn. Okay, is to learn. Third advice I give to you guys is don't give yourself an excuse to be bad. Don't say, this is my first time. I haven't done this before. Why? Because what's happening is that even puts God down. Like then there's no expectation for them at all. Oh, they're just listening to someone who's doing it for the first time. No, be confident in God working through you. Don't give those excuses, okay? Number four is it's okay to say, I don't know during the lecture. It's fine, but make sure you get an answer for them and get the answer to them, right? Eventually. So tell them it's a great question, that you've never heard the question before and that you'll get back to them, all right? And then last but not least is don't worry about the length of the lecture. As long as they understand the point, okay? As long as they understand it. If they didn't understand it, it's okay. You can review some things with them. But if they understood it, it's better than like a 2-hour lecture or a 90-minute lecture, even an hour lecture if they don't understand. The key point is, do they understand what the lesson is about? Okay, so those are the top five things that I would recommend for all beginning lecturers. Yes, there's so much to learn, but don't worry about it, right? It's your first lecture, which means trust in God more than anything else. We really, really do, all right? So that is the end for the question of the day. Hope it's something that will help a lot of you beginner lecturers too with those five tips. And I hope it's something that you guys will really be able to use for the future. You know what? I'm going to tell you this right now. There is always a need for a lecturer. Always. Okay, so just know that there's always a need for lecturers, so go ahead and learn how to lecture, all right? So that is the end of the word study for today on this question answer Thursday, which means we're going to get into today's song of choice, and Thursday's my favorite because it is Boy Band Thursday. So what's happening on this Boy Band Thursday? Of course, the theme is about love, so I'm going to go into Westlife, and this is one of my favorite songs. Funny as this is, it was recommended to me by Pastor Joan. Yeah, long, long time ago. This Westlife with I Lay My Love on You. Hope you guys really enjoyed this. I know a lot of you love Westlife too. I like them. They're not my favorite, but I like them too. They're really, really good. So everyone, this is a song of choice for today's Boy Band Thursday. This is Westlife with I Lay My Love on You.
Just a smile and the rain is gone. Hardly believe it, yeah. There's an angel standing next to me, reaching for my heart. Just a smile and there's no way back. Can hardly believe it, yeah. But there's an angel calling me, reaching for my heart.
My love on you, it's all I wanna do.
And there it is. That is Westlife with I Lay My Love on You on this Boy Band Thursday. Hope you guys really, really enjoyed that. All right, guys. So this is bringing us into today's Thursday segment. We have a special new thing on sports science, and this is from Yuen Yu in Singapore. She is competing. She runs for her school, and she's learning a lot of different things, and she's going to go over 5 weeks. Now, I do have to give an apology because I played week one's version again. Last week. So you heard you heard the first episode for 2 weeks in a row. This is now the second version. I am sorry that if you guys heard the first of the series 2 weeks in a row, but here's the second one. I'm very sorry about this, but I hope you guys really, really enjoy this. This is Yuen Yu from Singapore. Hope you guys enjoy this with some sport science for us to learn.
Hello, my name is Yuen Yu, and welcome to this segment on sports and exercise, where I share about sporting principles which people in the field of sports use to create training programs for athletes. I hope that today's sharing can let you understand about the word from another perspective and serve as practical advice for those who are starting out or have been exercising regularly. Last week, we covered the principle of adaptation, where our bodies improve when we exercise, and what we do in our daily lives, like resting and eating well, are equally important to training time. This week, we will move on to another principle of progressive adaptation. In other words, to become stronger, you need to increase your training load, and you should gradually increase your training load. As you increase your training load, overloading shouldn't take place, but you should increase gradually over time. If you increase too much, your body can't adapt to the load, leading to injury and illness, which is something we definitely want to avoid. Then, how can we ensure that we are progressing gradually? A very general rule of thumb is to keep to around a 10% increase and to only progress when you have successfully done the current training session. There are more accurate ways to measure your training load, but for a start, keeping around 10% increase is suitable. For example, if I run 2 kilometers this week and it was manageable, then during the next run, I can increase to within 2 to 2.2 kilometers. For strength training, this would mean doing 10 push-ups in one training session, and moving on to 11 to 12 push-ups is appropriate. Another example is if I'm someone who wants to develop my fitness after a period of inactivity, then I should gradually step up my training program by progressing from jogging slowly before I run at higher intensities. While doing so, exercise regularly so that your body can adapt to the training load. In this way, this relates to how it is a gradual history as we change ourselves. We need to have the right expectations and patience when it comes to change. Knowing that change takes time, I also had a transition in mindset. There are times we do a workout and we really want to give up because it's just so hard to keep up. There are also times where we did all the right things, but yet you still can't see much improvement. And there are also times where we train for a long period of time but fail to perform at a competition. In times like this, knowing that change takes place with time, and as long as you get back up and improve in the long run, then that is the key. Similarly, having this mindset applies to when dealing with other people. With newcomers listening to the word, remember that each of them have their fair share of struggles that they need time and effort to overcome. Next, when it comes to increasing your training load, aka also known as making the workout harder, there are many different ways to do so. For example, in running, the more common ways are to increase the distance that you run as well as the speed that you're running at. And when it comes to strengthening exercises like doing crunches, the common ways to increase your training load include doing more crunches in one sitting and holding onto weights as you do the exercise. Besides these common ways, there are in fact more ways that you can make the workout harder. One example is called chaos. What exactly is chaos? Chaos refers to creating unpredictable circumstances that the athlete has to react to and overcome. This allows them to perform at high pressure and under unexpected circumstances. For example, this can be listening to music that the athlete does not like while performing the sport. If you're starting out in sports, chaos is probably something you want to do later on when you become more competent in the sport. Nonetheless, I think chaos helps us to view challenges in a really interesting way. One instance includes Michael Phelps. Michael Phelps was one of the most successful Olympians, achieving 28 gold medals over the span of 5 Olympics. How his coach used chaos in his training was to hide his goggles so that Michael Phelps would swim without them. His coach also deliberately arranged late pickups so that Michael Phelps would miss his meals and swim with hunger. His coach even cracked his goggles so that they would fill up with water and obstruct Michael Phelps' vision in the pool. This gave him a strong mentality to do well even in unexpected times. Eventually, all of this came in handy when his goggles cracked during his 2008 Olympics 200 meters butterfly. In the end, he won despite the mishap. In this way, this let me realize about turning crisis into opportunities even more, where mishaps in our life can be seen as advanced training for ourselves. With this, we can understand better about the word Sansinim teaches us on turning crisis into opportunity, that crises are in fact so valuable and useful in making ourselves. Thank you for listening to the end. Today we covered the principle of gradual adaptation, where our bodies improve gradually with gradual progressive loading. What do you think about this principle? Stay tuned for next week where we will cover another principle. Goodbye!
And there it is, another wonderful segment. That is segment number 2 from UNU in Singapore for sports science. Hope you guys really, really enjoy that. She is a competitive runner at her school, so it's amazing, all the amazing things that she is learning and helping us out with. All right, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that segment. Leave a comment below if you want to say anything to UNU, or you could just call her YY. But I am very, very grateful and thankful she's doing this 5-week episode here, and I know that a lot of us are going to learn from it too. All right, it is Thursday, which means tomorrow is Friday. We're going to be at the end of the week, super happy about this. Everyone, have an amazing, awesome Thursday, and we'll see you guys again tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive, 117.8. You're soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly, so let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion, nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know. I'm burning with desire and the passion, nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know.